Years ago tonight, Gina DeJesus, Michelle Knight, and Amanda Berry were rescued on Seymour Avenue. It was a dark moment for the Clark Fulton neighborhood, where they were held captive for the better part of a decade. But since then, the surrounding neighborhood has fought to change its reputation. In this News 5 original, Kevin Berry explains how it's trying to balance investment with preservation.
For the last few decades, Old San Juan Jewelers has sat on Clark Avenue, just a few blocks away from Seymour.
I remember when they found the girls. I remember when they disappeared. I remember taking flowers to their porch.
Alexandra Pagan's family jewelry business was cemented in the community by 2013, when three girls were rescued just down the block.
It was just something so emotional for us, because we did experience that loss with that family.
Yeah, in 2013, the neighborhood was certainly in a tough spot.
Ricardo Leon at the Metro West Community Development Organization says even after the national attention died down, Clark Fulton had a reputation that scared people away.
I think a lot of folks thought, this neighborhood might not be the right neighborhood to invest in.
But after a few years, the interest came back. New investments and construction means Clark Fulton now has a different issue.
It gets a little scary, to be honest, because we don't want gentrification to take over.
We need to create interventions to stop that displacement from happening, right? We're at that point in time now.
The boards that once hid abandoned buildings now conceal new multi-million dollar projects. A massive crane at Greg Zucca's Metro Health Hospital shows everyone how a $1 billion investment can make a difference.
That really sent a signal to other developers, to other investors, to the financial community, that this is not a neighborhood that we're going to abandon. This is not a neighborhood that should be abandoned.
The recently converted Pivot Center creates a community arts and performance space just feet away from Seymour Avenue. New housing options are scattered throughout the neighborhood, converting old factories into residential units that are now affordable.
And when I say affordable, I'm saying one bedroom, $550, $600, which it really is affordable to the neighborhood.
Councilwoman Jasmine Santana says she hopes long-term residents can be the ones moving into those spaces. A neighborhood plan being drafted right now will show future developers what the community needs in their next project, while preserving its Latino heritage.
So that Latinos could have access to that, because otherwise we won't have anywhere else to go.
The Northeast Ohio Hispanic Center for Economic Development is getting involved too, raising more than $9 million right now to buy this former flooring distribution warehouse and turn it into Central Via 25. Denise Contreras says it'll be a market that brings jobs, food, and a place for local businesses to thrive.
We're addressing the issue of space, and then we're addressing the issue of affordability by being able to have multiple businesses in one location.
Out of tragedy, it's a community with momentum that's heading in the right direction.
For the first time ever, it feels like people want to be here. They want to park their dollars here.
The challenge now is making sure those dollars work for everyone. In Cleveland, I'm Kevin Barry.